That Elizabeth Warren, okay, is never going to get old. We're going to play that all the time. All right, welcome back to the show. It is the Vegas Take, Sharp and Shapiro. So glad you could join us. You know, it's kind of rare. I go after, you know, a Democrat on the stage, but when I feel it is needed, I have no problem in doing that. And I am not an Elizabeth Warren fan. I am not a Hillary Clinton fan. I have been very open and honest about that. I would never vote for either of them. Welcome back anyway. Joining us on the show right now, we always love having this guy on because we got to talk a little bit about the 2020 upcoming Oscars, the Lori Loughlin new charges, Matt Lauer. Oh, there's so much to get to, and what better person to talk about that? We call him the Hollywood conservative. He is Mr. X. He's a longtime producer in Hollywood and happens to be a Donald Trump supporter. That's why we love having him on. Mr. X, thanks for coming on. How you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you, gentlemen?
Doing good. Doing good. So much to get to in such a short period of time. I want to quickly touch on this. You might have heard this. Steve Harvey's daughter-in-law, I think it was her stepdaughter, actually, gets into this car crash in Beverly Hills. She hits a parked car, texting and driving. Then she tries to leave the scene. My question is, I think it's despicable, her behavior. Why was she not taken into jail to spend the night in prison?
I have no idea. I mean, it's an unanswerable question, kind of like, why is Steve Harvey a celebrity? These are just questions that will never be answered by anyone.
Well, that's true. That's fair. I never found Steve Harvey to be very funny, but the fact that his stepdaughter is buying these Gucci bags in Beverly Hills gets me very, very upset. All right, let's talk a little about these Matt Lauer accusations. I know you have an opinion on this. Do you think that NBC squash the reporting on Harvey Weinstein? What do you think about NBC, and what do you think about these Matt Lauer accusations?
Gosh, man, I think my opinion is not going to be popular, and I can't stand Matt Lauer. First of all, I've never liked him.
Neither have I.
Not a fan of NBC. With that said, clearly he and this woman had an ongoing sexual relationship, mm-hmm. whether it was him paying her for sex, or they were he was obviously cheating on his wife with her. Fine. It happens. It is what it is. One night, you know, apparently she's saying that he did something that went beyond what she was used to or whatever. I'm really sorry. I can't really get on her side on this, man. As crappy as it is, like, where's the line there? Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know what she said that night. Like, just imagine, like, there's these two people, and they've been having sex somewhat regularly for an extended period of time.
Right.
And then one night, they're both hammered, and he's like, I want to do this thing. And she's like, oh, no, should we? And he's like, yeah, let's do it. And then they do it. And then she's like,
Listen, Mr. X, I tend to agree with you on this one, and I am no Matt Lauer defender, just like you. I never thought he was a talented guy. I never understood why. And I'm really angry the fact that this guy is a millionaire and never has to work a day for the rest of his life. I think he's an absolute scumbag. But in this situation, I think I'm going to take your side on this. I do agree.
Here's the thing. Like, she didn't work for or with him, right? I didn't like dive deep enough in the story,
right?
To see.
But correct.
This was just a woman, right? This was really, let's call it what it is. She was probably an upper class prostitute of some kind.
It's possible. I mean, I don't know. I don't know the answer to that.
Fine. So, but regardless, like, for me, there's a distinction between sexual abuse or harassment in the workplace. That for me is far less excusable. And he was doing that as well, so he's obviously a crappy guy. There's no question about that. Because if you're in an office environment or on a film set or whatever, and you're doing that, like, that's so tough. Because then it's like, you're the boss, and they don't want to do anything. And, like, that really is a bad situation. But when we're talking about two adults who were consenting up to a point and then stopped consenting, like, that, honestly, for me, is scary in the other direction. Like, I have a girlfriend. She and I regularly have sex. One night, if, you know, she's like, I want you to pull my hair. I'm like, okay. And I do that. And then suddenly the next day, she's like, I really didn't like it when you pulled my hair. And I'm like, okay, sorry. And then
you complain about it, right?
A lawyer's calling me. And I'm like, whoa. You know, so anyway.
I'm just waiting for a woman to try to announce that she wants to pull my hair because there's no hair to be pulled. There's other things. Luckily there's other things to be pulled, but that's another story for another show. Yeah. Anyway, let's move on. Go ahead, JD.
So how often do you think that sleeping up the ladder actually happens in Hollywood,
Mr. X? All the time. I am a mid-level writer and director. If you want to have sex with me to forward your career, it's not going to help particularly, but I've had many propositions.
Hold on a second. You're telling me that if a really attractive woman wanted to play a part in one of your movies, and if you don't know who we're speaking to, it's the Hollywood conservative Mr. X, longtime producer. You're telling me if it's a woman you've always wanted to be with and you're single, and she said, gosh, you know, let's have some fun one night. You're telling me that wouldn't help her at all possibly get a role in your movie? Come on now, Mr. X, be honest.
It unquestionably would.
I appreciate your honesty.
I'm not the guy who sits around. But let me be more clear, though.
Sure.
The actual hard answer is no. But if it's a woman that I like and I'm dating, or like I have a lot of affection for that person, and it's her against another woman for a role, absolutely. Like, that definitely helps. That's human nature, and nobody can say that it wouldn't. That's just the bottom line.
I appreciate your honesty.
What's the standard context of a proposition like that consist of, Mr. X?
In Hollywood.
I mean, it ranges. For me, I get either, hey, let's grab a drink and talk about your script. And I'm like, okay. And then it's like clear that it's like, they're asking me if I'm single, asking me, you know, oh, you're so cute. That's kind of the like standard sort of like actress way of like, let's hang out. And listen, I don't fault them for it, man. Use what you got. Like, men are disgusting and we make decisions.
Did you ever have a guy do that to you?
Yes. I've had that a few times as well.
Give me a story. Okay. Hold on, was it Kevin Spacey, by the way? Was it Spacey?
I wish.
Okay. But seriously, you're a straight man. You're a good-looking guy living in Hollywood. You're a producer. You're well-known out there. Give me a story. So you're telling me a male actor wants to be in one of your movies. How does that go down? Explain that to me.
Well, I had a male actor in one of my movies who had already been cast one night, who is an extremely famous actor and very good-looking and gets with a lot of women, was very drunk one night with me, and we were at a bar, and he told me that women are not the only thing he's into, and he's always thought I'm very good looking, and I, you know, wanted, almost threw up, you know, that's just not my thing at all. But yeah, it's happened to me, and
is it Bruce Willis?
No.
Oh, okay.
I love that guy. Like, he's a legend. You know, I'm
going to
take one for the team.
Mr. X, have you ever cast an extremely, just a markedly untalented but beautiful woman in a film just because she slept with you?
No, you put the nail on the head right there. I'm extremely passionate about my work.
Right.
But again, you have two or three. There are so many talented actresses in Hollywood, and so many of them are beautiful and amazing and ambitious and cool, and opportunities are slim for real good material. And I respect the hustle, and I respect, and when a girl starts flirting with me because they want a role, I'm aware of it for what it is, and I'm like, okay, cool, I see what's going on here. But in the end, I'm never gonna cast anyone for that reason. And if they suck, I'm gonna say, look, we can date, I would love to, you're incredible, but I don't think you're right for anything
I would imagine these situations in Hollywood happen all the time, where a man gets with a woman and she's trying to get a role, and then she sleeps with him and he does not put her in the movie. What does the woman do next? I mean, there's really nothing she can do, right? Do you think?
Well, it used to be, you know, just goes, oh, darn. Now they write a book about it and go on.
Right. I imagine that's happened with Harvey Weinstein multiple times then.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
All right. Well, let's.
Harvey's a monster. There's no question about that. But also, again, like, at the height of his power, there were a lot of actresses who are, and that's the crazy thing about the whole, like, Me Too and all this stuff is, like, go walk down the street in Hollywood and talk to actresses. And I would say 8 out of 10 would be like, oh, yeah, I had sex with Harvey Weinstein. The height of his power, get a role, be in Shakespeare in Love, be in Good Will Hunting, be in Pulp Fiction. I would have done horrible things. They're totally open about it. Like, there's just a very small, very loud media-driven portion of society that, like, go crazy about this sort of thing. Whereas, sure. like, I talk to a lot of women who are liberals, they're feminists, and they're respectable women, and they're like, I don't know, I mean, I'll do whatever it takes. I want to act. I want to be seen. And they hustle hard. It's this unspoken thing.
Sure. No, understandable. If you're just joining us, we're speaking with Mr. X, Hollywood conservative. The reason why we call him Mr. X, doesn't want to be known by name on this show. The reason for that is he is a Donald Trump supporter, and there are not many conservatives in Hollywood, and if there are, they're certainly not speaking out on it. Mr. X, I wanted to ask you, do you think that the upcoming 2020 Oscars will be probably the most politically divided show that we've ever seen?
I mean, of course. The Oscars are absolutely a ridiculous forum of liberal blowhards complaining about things and then going home to their multi-million-dollar mansions with their legions of slaves. And, you know, that like I call it the Meryl Streep syndrome. But, yeah, I mean, because there's an upcoming election, you're going to get so many of these obnoxious liberal actresses and actors who said, you know, they're going to go up and thank you. We have an election coming up and the balance of our country is at stake and our lives, and we need to vote this guy out of all. And the crowd's right. going to go wild, and everybody watching is going to roll their eyes and probably mute and wait until the next award is being announced.
All right. So Mr. X, Martin Scorsese said something kind of interesting last week. He stated that Marvel films aren't cinema. And then one of the Coppolas actually followed suit with that earlier this week. What are your thoughts on that? Do you disagree or agree?
I agree completely, wholeheartedly. I remember this was about 10 or 12 years ago now when Avatar was nominated for Best Picture and getting a lot of buzz. I liked Avatar, but I was hoping and praying and rooting for it to lose every Oscar category. Like, I make movies. These giant CGI things, it's more like going to an amusement park. Like, these are not movies. Like, they are, and technically they have cameras filming actors doing things, so I guess by definition they are movies. But no, I mean, these are not, like, and first of all, Scorsese is a god. Like, anything that he says with regard to films is correct. It doesn't matter whether you agree or disagree. And Coppola is, you know, in the same category. But yeah, I fully agree. Like, these are not cinema. They're not film. They're not, you know, the budgets on these things are astronomical. You know, like, it's just, there's not my kind of thing.
Mr. X, what do you think about the Lori Loughlin new charges that have come up in the last few days? What do you think about that?
You know, my opinion might not be popular on this. I think this is blown massively out of proportion. I think that I don't understand what the difference is between offering some official or something like that 25 or 50 or 100 grand or building a new gym for the school and then your kids are getting in. Like, I feel like this is something that happens in a different way at colleges across the country. And I just... She obviously was trying to get her kid into a school, and, you know, I'm not, like, it sucks if that kid gets in over another kid who's more deserving, blah, blah, blah.
Mr. X, I want to read to you a little bit of what Loughlin said. She feels that the U.S. government is looking for a quote-unquote scapegoat and now fears that there's no way to avoid a moderately long prison sentence. Do you agree with her?
Absolutely. I do agree. I think that's what happens with this type of thing. I kind of liken it, because we're talking about college, to like NCAA sanctions, you know, like Reggie Bush with USC. Like,
right.
They just try to, like, so massively punish someone in the hopes that future people won't do it. When they know it's not that bad what happened, and it's the punishment completely doesn't fit the crime. And it's, you know, that's what they do.
All right. Well, here's my opinion on this whole thing. Obviously, this is a family with a lot of money, and I think she feels like because she's rich, because she's wealthy, maybe the laws don't apply to her. Maybe she obviously wants the best for her daughter, but yet she doesn't want her daughter to have a proper education, doesn't want it to be earned, wants it to be a fake education. Meanwhile, there are other kids out there that don't come from wealthy families, that work hard, that get good grades, but because Lori Loughlin has a lot of money, her child gets to go to a school while somebody else does not get to go into that school. I mean, I'm going to disagree with you all a little bit on this. I don't feel bad for Lori Loughlin as well. I think she is... what she did was horribly wrong. Did she commit a murder? No. But I do believe this is a serious crime. And I believe if you're a wealthy person out there and you don't think the rules apply to you and you just want, you know, listen, people that are wealthy, they have life a lot easier than those that don't. I don't care what anybody says. But in this circumstance, there are kids out there that are working very hard and doing it the right way. And because of her actions and the actions of others, there are some kids that maybe were not able to get into the college that they wanted to get into, and they deserved it a lot more than her daughter did.
Yeah, I don't disagree. And I mean, this is going to be breaking news, but being wealthy, you are afforded special privileges.
Sure.
And especially in this country. And the bottom line, like, so then do you say that, so do you believe then that the line is if a private person like Lori made a donation to the school and, like, let's say built a new gym or built something that other kids were able to use, do you think at that point that the school should be able to say her kids can get in?
It's a good question. It's a very good question, and here's the best way I'll answer it. I don't agree with Jared Kushner getting into Harvard for his father doing exactly what you're talking about. His father donated $5 million to Harvard. You know, we have a guy on the show all the time. He was a former Democratic presidential candidate. His name is Seth Moulton. I'm sure you've heard of him. He's an extremely intelligent guy, and this has nothing to do with politics. It just has to do with the fact that not only is this guy a war hero, but he's a guy that is extremely intelligent and worked hard in school. It doesn't come from a rich family. Those are the kinds of people that I want to get into Harvard. And if a guy like a Seth Moulton doesn't get into a Harvard because a guy like Jared Kushner, who got average grades in high school, has a father with a lot of money, then something needs to change in society. To me, that is wrong.
I don't disagree with you about that. Although, again, like, my opinion is generally a little different than what I think a lot of people have. And one thing I think, college doesn't mean anything anymore.
Sadly, you're right.
You're gonna be, you want to be successful? Go out and be successful.
Graduate school matters.
Lori Loughlin and kids are going to be fine anyway, whether they go to college
or not. Mr. X, I agree. Listen, I agree with you. I do think college is overrated. I do feel like 90% of what you learn in college, depending on what you want to do, you're probably never going to use in your life, sadly. So listen, I don't disagree with you on that whatsoever. I'm just going by, you know, the laws of the land. And
of course you're right. Of course you're right, man. Like, rich people should not be able to buy their way into things and get opportunities that other people with less means cannot get. It happens all the time. You go into a restaurant in Hollywood and you're at a table or you want a table and, you know, Selena Gomez walks in and says she wants that table, they're giving it to her. I mean, that is life, and it's unfortunate and it sucks, and don't go to that restaurant again, you know? Like, you know what I mean? Like, it's unfortunate. I don't know. I don't love the victim mentality. That's never how I've lived my life, and I'm kind of like, of course, it's unfair, but, you know, that's life.
Right, rise above it. So I'm going to ask you I'm going to ask you a sports question here. We're actually interviewing Jose Canseco next. Do you have anything that you would like to ask Jose Canseco?
No, I'd have to think about that. I love Jose Canseco. I'm serious. I think that it's so great how much he opened the door about steroids in Major League Baseball. And honestly, my opinion on steroids, let everybody take steroids. I don't care. Like, let's see how hard a human can actually.
As long as people aren't dying, as long as people are doing it the way they're supposed to do it. Yeah.
They want to kill themselves with steroids? Do it. I don't care. Like, it's everybody's still juicing. It's impossible to detect the steroids. Why don't you ask Jose? Actually, I'd be curious about this. I'm sure you were going to already ask him. Does he think that with all of the sanctions and suspensions and everything that Major League Baseball has done, that people are still juicing? I would love to hear
I'm sure he'll
that.
Say the answer is yes, but you know what? We're going to ask him about that, and we're also going to ask him about A-Rod. He got involved in A-Rod and J-Lo. Certainly.
And I have a very controversial question to ask him, so you should listen in.
We're going to ask him some good questions. But you know what, Mr. X, this has been a very good, educational, and lively conversation. I always appreciate it when you come on. Always a great talk. We don't always agree on everything, but I always love to hear your sides of it.
I know is I'm definitely going to be getting all of the actresses I sleep with to sign NDAs from here on out. I'm having my lawyer draft them and leave them on my bedside table.
Is your lawyer Michael Cohen?
Yes, it is, actually. So
you're going to have a stack of non-disclosure agreements on your desk very, very soon. Mr. X, thank you so much for joining us. We always appreciate it, my man. Have a great week.
All right.
Thanks a lot, Mr. X.
All right, there you go. That is the Hollywood conservative, as we like to call him, Mr. X. He's actually lost jobs as a producer because of being a Donald Trump supporter. I do not support that. I do not agree with it. We all know Hollywood is very, very liberal. I think people are entitled to their opinions, but it should not affect this type of opinion. I'm talking about a political opinion. As long as you're respectful about it, whether you're wearing a MAGA hat or you have a Donald Trump flag or you're openly a Donald Trump supporter, that should not affect whether somebody hires you or not in the workplace. In this case, being a producer, a Hollywood producer in the movies. I think that is completely ridiculous and it's wrong. And I've always supported anyone to be able to express their opinions when it comes to politics. We talked a little bit about this yesterday, but, you know, you should be able to have a Hillary Clinton bumper sticker or a Donald Trump bumper sticker without being harassed. But with that being said, you also have to understand that there are consequences for your actions. If you go out there with a MAGA hat, I hope nobody bothers you. I really do. But you have to assume that if you're in an area that there's a lot of liberals around and you're wearing some Donald Trump stuff, you're probably, unfortunately, you're going to get harassed.
Again, it's not a consequence. To me, consequence implies wrongdoing. Wearing a MAGA hat is not wrongdoing. Okay. Robbing a grocery store is wrongdoing. Murdering somebody is wrongdoing.
Well, there are different levels of consequences. Like I said, when you walk into the Raiders stadium wearing a New England Patriots jersey when the Patriots are there, you're damn right that's a consequence. You can support your team. You're not doing anything wrong. But the consequence of that is you're probably going to be harassed. People are probably going to bother you. If you go to a Yankees game in Yankee Stadium wearing an Astros jersey and you're at the urinal, somebody might throw a beer at you. That happened the other day. That is a consequence. All right, we're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, this is going to be awesome. We are going to be speaking to the legend himself, baseball legend Jose Canseco. He's actually opening up a new car wash in Las Vegas. We're going to ask him about the World Series. We're going to ask him about a whole plethora of things. Maybe we'll even bring up Madonna. Who knows what happens in these interviews? We'll take a quick break. We'll be back right after this with Jose Canseco. You're listening to The Vegas Take right here on the all-new 101.5 FM, 720 AM, KDON.